Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my Lady Boss YouTube channel. So today we're going to talk about how to become a strong and independent person where you can be very dependent on yourself and just learn how to be self-sufficient. Because in my opinion, I really believe that being an independent person is a lifestyle. You know, we have to go through the process, we have to learn how to grow, we have to go through that whole entire journey to become this strong and independent person. And it doesn't just happen overnight. So that's why I came up with a few tips and I would love to share them with you. But before we do get started, please feel free to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I do post videos every single Thursday, and I will link my new Instagram handle down below so you can give me a follow on social media. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the tips that I have on how to become a strong and independent person. My strong and independent tip number one is to acknowledge and own your weaknesses. So in reality, your weaknesses actually create a lot of strengths. So as long as you're able to accept your flaws, own it, and decide to improve upon it, you'll definitely be unstoppable. Because when you decide to work on your weaknesses, you start to go on this journey and learn so much about yourself in order to really help yourself become a better person. And at the end of the day, no one is going to be able to knock you down or make you insecure because you already know what these things are that you need to work on. So as long as you stay focused on that and you decide to get to know yourself and get to really know those weaknesses and try to really do something to change a positive outcome out of it, you'll definitely get closer to becoming a stronger and more independent person. My strong and independent tip number two is to be self-supporting. So you have to rely on yourself to be able to gain your own stability, because if you're going to continuously rely on others or be dependent on other people, it's definitely going to hinder you. Like for example, if you're gonna use your parents as a fallback to help you pay for your rent bills or to give you gas money or to pay for your phone bills, that has got to stop, because those are things that you should be able to do as an adult and to support yourself. And another thing too is I've heard so many people who complain or will cry about the crappy job that they've had, and it's like you need to go ahead and be proactive to get a better job in order for you to help pay your own bills. Or another thing too is if you're still living at home when you should be living on your own, you need to make moves and you need to strategize on how to be able to live on your own, because at the end of the day, these are all the things that you should be able to do as an adult. Like there's no excuses. All of these things are things that you can be able to do on your own as long as you set yourself up for success. If you think about it this way, what if you actually didn't have any of these things as a fallback? Like what if you didn't have parents there that were gonna help support you financially? Like what if you didn't have nice parents who would let you live out of their place until you were able to afford to get a new one? You know, it's just like, what if you didn't have that as a fallback? You would have to figure it out eventually on your own. So it's just like, don't even think about having certain things as like a safety net. That's where a lot of people have a hard time growing up in that sense and trying to become their own independent person, is because they have their fallbacks. And a lot of people out there, including myself, I understand this because a lot of people are very privileged. So in order to become a strong and independent person, you have to learn how to help your own self succeed in all aspects of life and help yourself get to where you need to be in your life. That is the only way that you're ever going to be able to become a very strong and independent person. My strong and independent tip number three is no settling. So over here, we are not going to settle, no mediocrity, none of that whatsoever. Because everybody deserves to get equal respect from others, to be able to get the same amount of effort that they put into something, you know, and just to be able to be genuinely happy. And none of those things will come if you decide to settle. If you're feeling that, you know, you are settling a little bit with the people or the situations around you, but you're going to have to leave those things behind. You're gonna have to leave those people, leave those situations, even though it could be very, very tough to do. Just know that there's going to be such a positive outcome on the other side of it, because this is the only life that we get to live, and I don't think there should be any room for anybody to settle, because if you're going to do that, it's gonna make you feel very unhappy, and at the end of the day, you're not gonna be this strong person that you can be. And your independence definitely get taken away. So keep that in mind when you're working on yourself, is to not settle for anything less than what you deserve. My strong and independent tip number four is not needing assurance from others. So you just have to learn how to be immune to other people's judgments, because no matter what, people are always going to have an opinion about you. And unfortunately, sometimes it even comes down to people passing judgments even though they've never met you personally. And that's just something that we just have to deal with and that we just have to work through and have a tough skin when it comes down to it. And during your journey of trying to work on becoming a strong and independent person, just keep in mind and just remember this, that you will never need to owe anything to anybody else, to prove yourself to anybody, and definitely that you do not need any assurance from other people in order to become this better person. My last and final tip is no excuses. So strong and independent people really don't give any excuses for anything. They do take a lot of the responsibility and ownership on themselves. And that's something where, you know, anybody and everybody can work on that. I know that it's very hard because a lot of us, you know, we like to play the victim card, and that just gives us a way to justify things of it being okay to do. But it's really, really not, and it's really hurting you if you're always trying to play the victim and always trying to give and blame other people for certain things or problems in your life. Like, this is where you need to work on it, grow as a person, and really take so much ownership to be able to grow and become an independent person. So the next time that you decide to play the victim card, try to stop yourself. Try to reflect back and say, what can I do in order to help or fix my problems? Because at the end of the day, the only person who is going to affect is you, and it's going to hinder your capabilities, and you're not going to be able to become this great, phenomenal person that you actually really can be. Alright guys, I'm going to close out this video. I hope that you thought my 5 tips on how to become a strong and independent person were really helpful and that you can use this in your day-to-day lives. And I just wanted to also say too, I really appreciate you guys so much for watching my videos, to subscribing to my YouTube channel, to give me thumbs ups on my videos. I truly, truly greatly appreciate it. The support does not go unnoticed. So I just wanted to say that. But other than that, I will see you all in my next week's video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye guys.